Hello everyone, welcome to Stranded. This game is about an astronaut who comes out of cryostasis and finds themselves trapped on an unexplored planet. You can grab it from the official website. I'll have a link in the description to where you can check it out for yourself. And it seems like it's a slow, contemplative sort of game. So, as is usual, I'm going to take it slow and just really take my time and absorb things. Also, apologies in advance for the state of my voice. I'm currently recovering from a cold, so it's a bit stuffy and weird sounding. But I'm gonna power on through. Okay. Release pod doors? Yes. Let's come out of our little protective cryostasis. And here we go. 152 tanks remaining. Looks like everything on the ship is working except the engines. Looking at this. Core is okay, auxiliary is okay, engines are not. Which would explain why I'm stranded. I can't take off. Visually causes you to be stranded, doesn't it? Let's go outside. Look at this view. It's beautiful. Might be more beautiful if it wasn't for the fact that I might actually die here. Let's head back inside. Yeah, the art in this game is... the art is really, really good. Beautiful. Same with the music and the sound design, in general. Alright, so this is my map. Which, at the moment, is not very helpful. It just shows the two locations I've already been to. I believe this is here, and this is where I... yeah, this is where I just was, over on the right. Let's see what's through here. What is that I just saw moving away? There was something on the left side of the screen that just, like, floated away. I'm gonna chase it down in a second, but, yeah. My craft doesn't look to be in a very good condition. I'm actually amazed more on the inside isn't broken, looking at this on the outside. Okay, let's see if I can go figure out what that thing was. Yeah. It's definitely alive. It looks like a gigantic stone creature. Where's it going? Obviously a lot of intelligence on this planet. No doubt about that. Let's leave that for now. Actually, let's go inside of it. Why, hello there. Those things are magnificent. They're huge. Well, they don't seem to want to hurt me or anything. They don't even seem to acknowledge my existence. I wonder if I can do something with them later. Because right now it doesn't look like I can actually do anything with them. Another temple. This one looks like it's falling apart, though. Whoops. I didn't actually mean to press that, but that's very strange. It doesn't work here. Can I step on these? No, it doesn't appear I can. It's like they're looking at me. It's like they're peering over. I find it very strange that so far I can't really interact with anything. Definitely not used to that. I think there's only one place I can think of to go, and that's right outside of my ship, but down. Yeah, right here. Oh. It's a pretty cave. Why, hello there. What is that? So much alien writing. I wish I knew what it said. I really do love the sound effects. Just listen to how detailed they are, just walking around this cave. Looks like they're inviting me inside. They always open right when I arrive. What in the heck is this thing? Well, judging by the size of this, I would say this is the maximum size the map could be. Unless it maybe expands to fit more. Again, it does not appear I can actually do anything. Okay, so now where to? Can't seem to interact with anything. I believe you can go back inside of your pod. And sleep or something like that? Maybe I should do that. Let's see. Yeah, do you want to rest and wait for nightfall? Let's do that. Maybe things will change at night. It used up one of the tanks, too. 151 remaining. Okay, should be nighttime, right? And so it is. Why, hello there. You weren't there before. Oh. Okay, so stuff definitely behaves very differently at night. Pretty. Oh my god. Yep, things are very different at night. Whoa. Hello? Seems to be blocking the way. Go head back to the cave. Look at all these life forms. This planet just seems to come to life. at nighttime. Seems like each of these rooms has their own color theme. This one's red, there's been blue, there's been, what, green too? I guess I should go back to the ship and wait until the daytime and see if something changes again. Let's go take a look out here for a second first. Wait for daylight, yes. Okay, did anything change? Well, it doesn't look like it there. Man, the music is great. I'm so confused about what I'm supposed to actually be doing, though. Can't seem to interact with a single thing in the world. Alright, so this is the place I was being blocked at nighttime. I couldn't go inside of it. Yeah, there's something special about this place. This is where my map messes up. I wonder what that means. Gotta mean something. I really want to be in here at nighttime, but how do I do that? I think I'm gonna wait until nighttime again, and see if maybe this time one of those things is not outside of it. What was that? That's not good. One tank's remaining, danger oxygen level's critical. Everything's broken. What the hell? Did it just, like, melt? It feels like it just died. Okay, something's happening here. Something's got to be different. Now that just happened. I haven't seen any more of those rock creatures. Let's see if I can find one. See what's up with them. Because it's one of them that just went into the water. Where did they go? Nothing to do but go back to the ship. Maybe I can rest until nighttime one final time. I'm not sure if it's gonna let me, though. Because, well, everything's broken. Oh, maybe I can. Okay. Zero tanks remaining. That's the last one. So this has got to be it. If I don't find a way off now, there's nothing else I can do. Hey, there's one. Yep, there goes all my power. Let's follow it. Seems like it's waiting for me. Like it wants me to follow. Like it's saying, go inside. Oh, it left. Oh, this is the messed up place. I wasn't able to enter here at nighttime before. I think this is the place. Yeah. Okay, so there's one. That's a symbol that was just in the place I was just at, right? It's like a flat line and a U. Hold on, let's go double check that. I think I should go into the others, too. See if I can get something to happen. Maybe I need to activate them. I'm not sure what I'm actually activating, though. Yeah, that is a symbol. You could even see it on the door. Okay, let's go check out the others. Yeah, what am I activating, though? What am I doing? Can only hope it's going to save me. Alright, I think there's one more. Okay, let's see if that does what I think it does. There's three of those things looking at me in that special room. And there's three of these glowy rooms, so I'm assuming I've just activated all three, whatever that does. Oh yeah, there we go. Got a light show going on in there. But what have I done? Became one of those. Do you want to start over? Not really. Oh, the game just shut down. I guess I survived. I'm alive. I'm not gonna run out of oxygen. I wonder if the game has multiple endings, or if that's it. The fact that it asks me to start over makes me almost think maybe it does, but maybe that's just the game being polite. Do you want to play again? I don't know. Strange. Yeah, I really didn't know anything. I knew very little about this game going in. I'd just seen a few articles on it. I loved the art. Just thought it looked just beautiful and eerie. And I love games that are just set on other places. In fact, let's start up the game again. I do want to start over. There we go, just so we can actually look at the game as I talk about it. Yeah, I didn't know very much about it. I just saw this art. And I thought it looked incredibly beautiful, and I love it when a game's set on an alien world. There's something about that I just really love. It's so fascinating. It's really not what I expected, though. It kind of takes the guise of a point-and-click adventure game. And thankfully, it doesn't have a lot of the silliness that often comes with that, such as an inventory filled with 50 items that you have to combine. I'm glad it doesn't have that, but I'm really surprised at just the lack of interactivity, actually. There's almost nothing you can actually interact with in the world. Virtually nothing. Which is very strange, just surprised me. Wasn't expecting that. So it's a very passive experience. Which I think actually kind of works, since you are stranded on an alien world. It actually does make sense to be pretty powerless, since you are. You're alone. You're stranded. You have no way off. So I actually think it kind of works. It just surprised me, is all. I I don't know. For some reason, though, I'm left a bit unsatisfied. I don't know why. I was just expecting something more. There's no doubt it's beautiful. The art is just gorgeous. The sound effects are wonderful. Just the footstep sound effects. Simple as they are amazing sounding. The music is great. But I'm still left feeling unsatisfied. I don't know why. Not exactly. I'm trying to figure it out, but I can't. I just realized. Look at this down here. Is this one of those stone creatures? Is that a corpse of one of the stone creatures, just like the one that went out there? It kind of looks like it. I wonder if this is where they come to die. I don't know, I just felt like there'd be more. I'm left thinking a rather uncomfortable feeling of, did I miss something? And I'm certainly gonna go look to see if there's some other endings or something. But I suspect there isn't. Just because, again, you don't seem to be able to really interact with anything in the environment. And if you can't interact with anything, then you can't really change anything. At all. Even the movement system is very strange. You can't move wherever you want. It seems like you can only move to predetermined points. And you can't even break out of the movement once you start moving. Like if I click here, and I click back, I have to wait. Which is very strange. It's like there's nodes that you can move to. Huh. Yeah, I'm left feeling like I don't really know what I just played. What did I just play? What did I just experience? I don't really feel like I understand the world at all. There's large stone creatures. It seems like maybe they kill themselves by going into the water. Or something happens when they go into the water. You can become one of them by going to three glowy things and then making the three glowy things come together and then boom, you're one of them. And plant life on this planet glows at night. Very vibrantly and beautiful. That's about it. Strange. I don't know what I was expecting, but I wasn't expecting that. I guess I'll just leave it at that before I go in a circle saying I'm left scratching my head, because that's pretty much it. I'm left scratching my head. I don't know, I wasn't too satisfied with it. I enjoyed it. It was interesting, but definitely not satisfied. I don't know. If anyone else checks out this game, or has any thoughts about it, let me know. I'm really curious what you think, if you got something else out of it, if you saw any other, if there's any other endings or anything else you can do that I've missed. Let me know, because I'm really curious. I just feel like I've missed something. That's all I feel like. I feel like I missed something. Like I played it wrong or something. Did I? I don't know. If you know, let me know, because I'm really curious. Alright, well, I hope you enjoyed my playthrough of Stranded. Thank you for watching.